Good morning, student. In the last class, in the trigonometric chapter, we have completed exercise 8.1. And today we will continue with the exercise number 8.2, which is based on the trigonometric angles. What is that? Sin theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosecant theta, secant theta, and cotangent theta. What that angle be based? We are going to do the problem today. Exercise number 8.2. What is the problem given here? Evaluate. For the theta value, sin theta, cos theta value, you have to substitute the value which you have taken from the tabular column and you have to find the answering values. Okay. First problem, what is given? Sin 60 cos 30 plus of sin 30 cos 60. What is the value of sin 60 cos 30? Sin 60 root 3 upon 2. Cos 30 root 3 upon 2. Sin 30 1 upon 2. Cos 60 1 upon 2. From the tabular column, you should memorize that one. So these are the four values. Substitute in this equation. Root 3 upon 2 into root 3 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2 into 1 upon 2. So 3 upon 4 plus 1 upon 4. If you simplify, your answer is 1. That is here. First question, first problem. Second problem. 2 tan square 45 plus of cos square 30 minus of sin square 60. What is the tan 45? It is 1. So 1 square. Tan square 45 whole square or tan square 45. Both are same only. So tan 45 is 1, 1 square. Cos square 30, cos 30 is root 3 upon 2 square. Then sin 60 is root 3 upon 2 square. Simplify this value. If you simplify, 2 into 1, 2 plus of 3 upon 4 minus of 3 upon 4 plus minus cancel. Your answer is 2. So similarly, third and fourth problem, you take it as a homework. Okay. Fifth problem. 5 cos square 16 plus 4 secant square 16 minus tan square 45 upon sin square 30 plus of cos square 30. Substitute the values. 5 into cos 16, 1 upon 2 square, f square is there, plus 4 into, this is inverse of cos, so 2 upon root 3 whole square, square is there, whole square. Tan 45 1 minus 1 square. Then here sin 30 is 1 upon 2 whole square, square is given. Then your cos 30 is root 3 upon 2 whole square. Then simplify this number. You will be getting final simplification. 15 plus 64 minus 12 upon 12 in the numerator. Denominator 1 upon 4 plus of 3 upon 4. It will become 1. So if you simplify the numerator today, 67 upon 12, that is the answer for the fifth question. So first question, what I have done? 1, second, third, fourth, homework, fifth I have done. In the second question, what is given? Some four options they are given. You have to select the correct option from that one by solving this tan, this angle formula, angle problem. So what is that? 2 tan 30 plus of 1 plus tan square 30 is there. Substitute the angle value 1 upon root 2, 30, root tan 30. Then 1 plus of 1 upon root 3, whole square. It is also tan 30, so it is square. Then you simplify, you will be getting root 3 upon 2. You are getting in number as an answer. So according to the option, what is this root 3 upon 2? It is nothing but sin 60, which is in option A. So sin 60 is root 3 upon 2. So like that option you have to select. From the answer, you see which angle you are getting the value of root 3 upon 2 sin 60. That is your answer. Second problem, similar to first problem, take it as a homework. Third one, sin 2a equal to 2 sin a. There some four angles they are given in the option. Which angle you substitute one by one, which angles satisfy left hand side and right hand side are equal means that is your correct angle. So I am substituting 0. 0 means both the right hand side and left hand side will be equal. So a angle equal to a option 0. That is your third problem answer. Fourth problem. 2 tan 30, 1 minus of tan square 30. What is tan 30? 2 into 1 upon root 3. So I have multiplied here. 1 minus of tan square. So 1 minus 1 upon root 3 square. Then I am simplifying this one. I am getting root 3. According to the option given A, B, C, D, what is the root 3 represent? Root 3 represent tan 60. That is C option. That is your answer. So in the second question, second problem you take it as a homework. Then in the third question, if tan a plus b equal to root 3, tan a minus b equal to root 1 upon 3, 1 upon root 3, what is the angle of a and b? It should be less than 90 degrees, they are telling. root 3, it is tan 60 equal to root 3. Therefore, a plus b should be 60, one equation. Similarly, tan a minus b equal to 1 upon root 3. For which angle of tan theta 1 upon root 3 will be the ratio? For tan 30 it is 1 upon root 3. So a minus b should be equal to 30 degree. So first and second equation solve the equation by two variable method. A and b is there. So solve it by the method that I am doing. Plus b minus b I am adding. So it is cancel. So 2a equal to 90. Therefore a equal to 45. Substitute this a in one of the equation. Then if you take the other side, 60 minus of 45, b will be 15 degree. So a is 45, b is 15. When you put here a plus b, it will become 60. A minus b, it will become 30. That is your third question. And fourth question is, you are all that do it as a homework. Read the statement, write the statement, analyze the statement and write me whether it is true or false. Okay. Up to this, in trigonometric chapter 8.2, 8.1, we have completed. Then 8.3, 8.4 is there based on complementary angle and trigonometric ratio. That in the coming class we will take. Okay.